friction home lab. You will find two related surfaces and determine the coefficient of friction between them. I'll get more into what related surfaces means later. We need to apply our ideas of two-dimensional forces in this case. What we're going to have here is a shoe on a tilted floor. We need to diagram the forces acting on the shoe. The forces acting on the shoe, of course, are its weight, which is the force due to gravity, which will act straight down, the normal force, which acts perpendicular to the surface, and friction, which acts in opposition to motion, which would be sliding down the ramp. Again, with our equation of the frictional force equal to mu, which is the coefficient of friction, times the normal force. If we add the three vectors, we should arrive back at where we started from, i.e., either the shoe is sliding down the ramp at a constant speed or hasn't yet begun to slide. We can relate the frictional force and the normal force using Sokotoa by looking at the tangent of the angle will be equal to opposite over adjacent, so tangent of our angle equal to frictional force divided by the normal force. Trust me, we are going someplace with this. Let's pull our frictional formula back out, where friction equals the coefficient of friction times the normal force. We're going to rearrange that to get the coefficient of friction equal to friction divided by the normal force. The more astute will notice a similarity here. If the coefficient of friction equals F over N, and the tangent of angle equals the coefficient of F over N, then the tangent of the angle also equals the coefficient of friction. So, if we can tilt our surface, all we need to know is the angle at which it starts to slide, and we'll be able to calculate the coefficient of friction without having measured a single force. For this lab, you will take your object and place it on a related surface. You will then tilt the surface until the object just starts to slide. Measure the angle of the surface with the floor. You will use this angle to determine the coefficient of friction. This will be the coefficient of static friction. To get the coefficient of sliding friction, simply lower the board until the object stops sliding. This new angle can be plugged into tangent, and you will get the new coefficient of friction. As I said at the beginning, I want related surfaces, not simply junk on a board. So, what do I mean by related surfaces? A shoe and the floor would be related surfaces. How do you tilt your floor? Not my problem. I would find other surfaces.